In this tutorial, I'll show you a fast and easy way to remove severe acne using Photoshop and its neural filter. By the end, you'll know exactly how to fix any portrait in minutes. Let's jump in. First, I'll open the image in Photoshop. Next, I'll head over to Filter and select Neural Filters. Then I'll turn on Skin Smoothing. And boom. Instantly, you'll see a nice improvement. Now, I'll increase the blur to 53% because we want that skin to look clean but still natural. And if you're thinking, what if I just max it out? Will it erase all the acne? No, not gonna happen. It'll only soften the skin, not make acne disappear completely. Once it looks good, I'll hit OK and move on. Next, I'll jump to the Layers panel and duplicate the layer because trust me, always keep a backup. Now, I'll go to Image, then Adjustments, and then click Invert. This will completely flip the colors. This step helps isolate the texture details, which we'll need for the next part. Then, I'll convert this layer into a smart object, so we can apply effects non-destructively. After that, I'll set the blend mode to Vivid Light, which might make the image look weird again, but it's all part of the process. Now, I'll go to Filter, then Other, and select High Pass. Here, set the radius around 40 pixels. This helps bring out fine details. Next, I'll again go to the Filter, then Blur, and then select Gaussian Blur. Set the radius to around 1.3 pixels. This keeps the details crisp, but not over-sharpened. At this point, the effect is applied to the whole image, which we don't want. So I'll add a layer mask and press Command plus Backspace to fill the mask with black. This will completely hide the effect. Now, with white as the foreground color, I'll grab the brush tool and carefully paint over the acne areas to reveal the effect exactly where it's needed. No more, no less. Once that's done, I'll select both layers and group them together. Then duplicate the group for backup and merge one copy. All right, that's one major step done. Now, let's refine things even further. Now, I'll grab the spot healing brush and quickly clean up any remaining dark spots. This part is straightforward. Just click on blemishes and Photoshop does the rest. And look at that. This image is really coming together now. The skin is looking smooth but still natural, just the way we want it. Next, I'll create a new layer and set its blend mode to color. Then, I'll use the eyedropper tool to pick a skin tone from an area with similar lighting. This helps keep everything consistent. With the brush tool, I'll carefully paint over any spots that still need a little color correction. To make sure it blends well, I'll lower the opacity to around 35%. Just enough to even things out without making it look fake. Now I'll repeat this process. Create another new layer, set blend mode to color, grab the brush tool, and do a final pass to refine the skin. Once you're happy with it, you can lower this layer's opacity to about 14%, just for a subtle touch-up. Later, I played around with different adjustments and color tones in layer 4, but they didn't quite work out, so I decided to ditch them. Now, if you notice any spots that need fixing, simply go back to the main layer and touch them up with the healing brush tool. All right, things are looking pretty solid now. Now I'll merge all these layers together and then create a duplicate, just in case any adjustments are needed later. Now head over to Filter, then under the Noise group, select Add Noise. Set the amount to around 3%, keep the distribution uniform, and hit OK. It looks like it could use a bit more, so let's add noise again, this time at 4.5%. And just like that, we've made some serious progress. There are still a few areas that need a little extra touch-up, so Generative Fill can come in handy here. This step is optional, totally up to you if you want to refine things further. So the severe acne is officially gone, and the skin is looking clean and natural. Here's the before and after comparison. Pretty satisfying, right? If you found this helpful, drop a like and check out the channel for more engaging tutorials. See you in the next one.